New advice about taking aspirin to prevent heart attacks, especially for people over the age of 60.
So when there's questions, you know who we always bring in because he can always help us out. Dr. Marc Gillinov joining us from the Cleveland Clinic to explain all of this. And it is something that has really, I think, shocked a lot of people, these changing guidelines. So what's the deal? What are they saying?
The deal is that you have to think of aspirin as being a medicine. Taking an aspirin is not like having a glass of water. Water has no side effects. Aspirin can have a side effect, and the side effect can be bleeding and ulcers, primarily GI tract bleeding. So with any medicine, you've got to weigh what's the benefit, what's the risk. And when you do the calculus now, if somebody has never had a heart attack, never had a stroke, has no cardiovascular disease, don't take an aspirin, because the risk of bleeding, stomach upset, outweighs any potential benefit. So that's someone who's never had heart attack, stroke, particularly you're 60 years old or older, have no cardiovascular disease, do not take aspirin. On the other hand, if you've had a heart attack or you've had a stroke, taking aspirin prevents further events or at least reduces their likelihood, because strokes and heart attacks most often involve formation of blood clots. Aspirin reduces blood clotting, which is why it can lead to bleeding. So if you've had a heart attack or stroke, aspirin is generally good. If you have not had one, especially if you're over the age of 60, aspirin is bad.
Now, is aspirin better than the other medicines that prevent clotting, or is it about the same, would you say?
It depends on what the person has and needs, because there are other medicines like Plavix, which are somewhat stronger than aspirin. And those are going to be prescription medicines for very specific people. And real anticoagulants, aspirin is antiplatelet.
Okay.
Stronger category anticoagulants like Coumadin. Those are under a doctor's prescription only.
And the side effects can be even worse with those.
Those cause even more bleeding. People who need a real strong anticoagulant like Coumadin or Eliquis, those are people who are taking really a heavy-duty medicine. But I think the main thing is don't think of aspirin as being completely innocuous. It's very helpful, very important in people who've had a heart attack, had a stroke.
Kind of question, kind of off subject just a bit. What about people who take Benadryl every day to go to sleep? There are a lot of people on the morning show, they'll take a Benadryl just so they can sleep. What do you think about that?
He's asking for a friend.
Generally, no long-term side effects.
Oh, my good.
People will become a little bit tolerant of it, meaning you might need a heavier dose over time. And I'm sure if someone does take them, you wake up with a dry mouth and what have you. But a lot of the over-counter sleep aids, like Advil PM, have Benadryl in them, and it's the Benadryl that makes you sleep.
Okay, that makes you feel better.
So, I mean, is there, I mean, I have a feeling I might know what you're going to say to this, but I mean, when you look at this and you think, okay, well then, what can I do if I'm someone who hasn't had a heart attack or a stroke? Exercise, I'm guessing. I mean, like, what would you say is something that they can do? Because when you take that away, they think, okay, it takes that security blanket almost away, I think, from some people. They felt like they were doing something good. So what would you suggest in its place almost?
Well, I think you're right. The idea, I can just take care of everything with one little pill every day. It's not that simple and it doesn't work. Exercise is key, good diet, stay in shape, don't smoke. And with all that, figure out what is my risk. Am I at high risk? Am I at low risk? How do I know that? I need to go to a doctor and find out what's my blood pressure, what is my cholesterol, specifically my LDL cholesterol, go over my family history, you know, did my parents have heart disease, do brothers and sisters have it? And that will inform how hard I should work at it. Because truthfully, if my LDL cholesterol, that's the bad cholesterol, is really high, I don't need aspirin. I need a statin like Lipitor.
Let me ask you this. This is like what we've been reporting all morning about the CDC, and kids can now get the COVID vaccine and the booster shots and all that stuff. Your reaction to what's happening with that?
I hope and pray that people will get these vaccines. I'm mystified by the anti-vaccine concepts. We all get vaccines when we're born. We all get vaccines when we're little. Measles, mumps, rubella, polio. You know why you've never heard of anyone, you've never met anyone who's had those diseases? Because of the vaccines, because they work. And this vaccine is incredibly effective and amazingly safe. So I think it's just truly remarkable.
What about people say, well, you got to get a booster shot, you know, so that there must be something wrong. We got to get a booster. What
do you get a flu shot every year.
Yeah.
Or at least you should get a flu shot every year. And these are way more effective than the flu vaccine for that. But you need a booster. It's probably going to be forever, every year, because immunity peaks when you get the shot, then it wanes a bit. Mm-hmm. And I'll tell you, getting a shot in the arm is a lot better than being one of the patients I'll see this morning in the ICU.
Wow.
That's not deep. The truth. You know, even us working in this business, it still can terrify you because you hear all these mixed reactions about things. But when you hear someone like this convey that to you, I mean, and that's why people need to talk with their doctors, because when they hear someone like you saying it is safe, I think it gives people a lot more peace of mind.
It's incredibly safe. I mean, it's a remarkable scientific achievement, maybe the most important medical achievement so far of this century, to develop those vaccines this quickly.
Mm-hmm.
Remarkable.
Wow. All right, then. Well, stamp of approval, Dr. Marc. Thank you, sir. Appreciate it.